Dr. Jay Singh and the other distinguished faculty and young budding students of this great institution. The mood looks very somber, and I don't think I am here to make it more, you know, somber or more dull. Early morning, there should be like birds chirp. There should be somewhat chirpy feeling should be there. Whereas I am looking at here and I'm finding that everybody is so pin drop silence. Nobody is even forcing a smile. So I thought, let me make my talk a bit different. With your permission, sir, I'll make it somewhat different. I thought let me try to do justice. First and foremost, I would like to thank the Indus Business School management for inviting me to this program. I think most of you are just joined this batch, am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. There are some faculties or no? It's only students. And I just wanted to know whom I am addressing. That's the main thing. I would like to put it, yes, I would like to, you know, in Hindi they say, pehle aap apni aupcharikta puri kariye, so I will also like to do that. Yes, I am thankful to the management of Indus Business School for calling me here, inviting me here. But at the same time, I thought I am more or less like a stepney. Do you understand stepney?
Yes.
You understand stepney? What is stepney? Somebody said, correct? What did he say? Extra wheel, yes. So I thought I am a stepney, in the sense because I got this message to come and talk to all of you. Today is 23rd. On 21st afternoon, say about 1:30 or 2:30, sometime in the afternoon. So I thought obviously that somebody else would have been wanting to invite, he or she for some reason couldn't come. So perhaps they would have scanned the radar and find somebody who was available to come. So perhaps I thought I am a stepney. So otherwise I had not known Mrs. Ramdas. I had not known anybody. Suddenly out of the blue I got a call. So come and address the students. So here I am. So I may not be the main speaker. I may be a stepney for all of you. Doesn't matter. Many times when you are out on a drive, you want to go in a car to some place, suddenly you find puncture ho gaya hai. What do? You replace the stepney. And it is the stepney's luck that stepney takes you around to wherever you want to go for your ride. I meant in all in a very lighter way, nothing serious in that, but at the same time, I don't know about, have you heard of Neil Armstrong? I don't know if it's a fact or a joke. There is a saying about him. He was not supposed to be the first man to land on the moon. I'm sure many of you would have read. It's there in the various Facebooks and WhatsApp. It goes on all the social media. The things are there. That somebody else was too, the main person. And he was a bit hesitant. He was a bit hesitant, should I not? You know, it's the moon. First time somebody is, a human being is going to another place called moon. Wo pair rakhne se ud jayega. You look at us. In the night, in our village or somewhere or some place, you get scared to walk because you are scared of there may be a snake. You know the house, your own backyard, but you get scared that there could be a snake, kuch aur ho sakta, gadda ho sakta, so you're so scared. So you can imagine what would have been gone in his mind. Aldrin, if I'm not wrong, his name was. that if I walk, if I land, if I touch my feet on this particular surface of moon, will I just get vanished? So by the time he said, tum utar jao. Hota na kai baar, tum chale jao. So I believe he told Armstrong, why don't you go? So though Armstrong is more famous, nobody knows Aldrin. So that is why I say many times what happens is the Stepney gets all the credit, not the main person. So I believe by the time, end of the day, you all will remember the Stepney had come here and perhaps he would have done some justice to all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning to each one of you. So I have come prepared, or I have come less prepared. I should use, because Debube yesterday when she spoke to me, Mrs. Ramdas, I said I'll confirm it by late in the evening. Yesterday early morning, 6 o'clock, I left for Delhi and came back late night. So honestly, I feel ashamed to say that I didn't have full time to do a real justice to all of you and make a preparation. So whatever I did, I just trying to, you know, take bits and pieces, and will try my best to see to it that I try to give you some tips for you, some information for you, how a corporate world, or what will you do after 2 years? What will be your life after 2 years? How will it be? Will it be hunky-dory? Will it be full of challenges? It will be challenges. Why do you say challenges? Is today not a challenge when you're studying in college? Challenges are there all over, throughout. Whether you're a small child in kindergarten, or you become the managing director of a company, so challenges will be there. You can't avoid challenges. It will be a different style, different levels, different intensity. But we will have challenges. Each one of us, whether we are educated, we are uneducated, our parents, they had challenges their own. Children, they will have their own challenges. But what I'm going to tell you is, you should look at you, what you will face after you come out of this great institution. And that, in some short words, I'll try to explain to you. First and foremost, let me congratulate each one of you for having secured an admission to such an institute and for such a program. Education in India, I'm again telling you, education in India is very privileged. If you look at the overall literacy rate of the country, it is really saddening. And when we talk about literacy rate, we say anybody who can read something, we call him or her illiterate. You're aware of that. There are very few states, fortunately, I come from a state where there's a 100% literacy. I come from a state of Kerala, so where there is a different thinking about literacy. I won't go into that, that's a different subject. But it's an important point that you people who are sitting in this hall today should feel privileged. You should congratulate yourself that you have come this far and you have come to almost the final stage of your educational career. Education is something which we cannot stop it. It will continue. At this age, I'm 64. At this age, I'm now thinking of learning something. And everyone, whether you are having a formal degree or not, it doesn't make a difference. What is important is you will have to continue this phase of learning, educating yourself, if you have to be successful in life. If you don't want to be successful, you can always चलो चले छोड़ो, क्या फर्क पड़ता है. बट इफ यू हैव सम एम्बिशन इन लाइफ, विच आई एम श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू सिटिंग इन दिस रूम इज हैविंग एन एम्बिशन. इज देयर एनीबडी हु इज नॉट हैविंग एन एम्बिशन? इज देयर एनीबडी हु इन दिस हॉल हु इज नॉट हैविंग एन एम्बिशन? सो ऑल ऑफ यू आर हैविंग एन एम्बिशन, गुड. सो आई एम श्योर बिकॉज ऑफ यू हैव एन एम्बिशन, दैट इज व्हाई यू आर हियर. इट इज नॉट दैट वो जमाना गया व्हेन पेरेंट्स विल से जा बेटा तुम जाके पढ़ो. नो, दैट जमाना इज गॉन. टुडे यू विल टेल योर पेरेंट्स आई वॉन्ट दिस कोर्स, आई वॉन्ट दिस प्रोग्राम, आई वॉन्ट दिस. व्हेन आई यूज टू स्टडी, आई नो आई डिड माई इंजीनियरिंग इन 1968, आई जॉइन एंड पास आउट इन 73. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल देर आर ओनली टू और थ्री चॉइसिस. इफ यू डू वेरी वेल यू आइदर गेट इन मेडिसिन और इंजीनियरिंग. And the choices are very limited. The number of colleges, yesterday in Delhi, I was talking to somebody. The number of engineering colleges which has come in the country today is enormous. I was reading the other day in the newspaper in Maharashtra, almost 50,000 seats are still yet to be filled in. In those days, the number of engineering colleges was so few and far that if you get good marks, you get it. Second thing, today the situation is so bad. I'm not making any aspersions, but still the situation is bad. If you have money, you can get admission anywhere. That's the situation today. It's unfortunate, but that's the way it is. So I'm coming back to you. All of you have an ambition. All of you are in this course. All of you have come to this program. So I said, all of you are very lucky. What is so important of this program? You know one thing? Can anybody say, what is so important about this program? When I'm saying this program, it's the program level at which you have come. You know, up to schooling is your foundation. When you build a building, when a foundation is built, you don't know the size of the structure, how it is going to happen. आप सड़क पे जा रहे हैं, कुछ बिल्डिंग बन रही है, फाउंडेशन हो रहा है. यू डोंट नो क्या बनने वाला, किस प्रकार हुआ, क्या है, हाउ इट विल लुक लाइक. सो दैट्स द स्कूलिंग, दैट्स द फाउंडेशन. इट टीचेस यू द फंडामेंटल्स. एंड आई एम टेलिंग यू वॉट इज टॉट इन दोज स्कूल डेज. It remembers. Simple. Don't you remember the tables? Don't you remember some nursery rhymes which we learn in schools, first standard, second standard, maybe sometimes even in. That's fundamental. That's foundations. It never goes. You want to erase it, it will not go. You may make a mistake. You're in table, you may make a mistake. Suddenly 7, 6 or 42, somebody may, very rarely, I don't think anybody can make somebody with it. So that is foundation. The next, this, you do some sort of a college basic education. So something is coming up. The building something, some thoda level tak aa gaya hai, par bhi malum nahi hai kya hone wala hai, kya hoga. This what you are going to do. This program, say the management program or the final. This is where actually the shape of the building somebody comes to know. You come to know that yes, yeah, iska facade aisa hoga. They'll be like this, the lintels will be like this, you get some idea. That, so ladies and gentlemen, you have come to that stage. Your foundations are over, fundamentals are over. You have come to a stage where you know, people who, your parents know, your friends know, अरे क्या है, अरे इनकी तो life बन गई है. Because you have come to that stage, that you have to, you, there are certain areas available for you where you can go, make a mark and do very well. So this particular program of 2 years program, what you have, is a very, very important program. Because which program is not important? If you ask your parents, they'll say dasvi bhi bahut important hai, higher secondary bhi important hai, graduation bhi important hai. I am telling you, this program is most important for you. Because you already crossed those levels. You come to a level where, which is important in terms of making a career. Selecting your career, selecting the job, people should select you, isn't it? So these 2 years are very important for you. You have to really slog in. Unfortunately, I'm not exactly aware about the curriculum of this institute, but if you know some of your friends who have either studying in IIM or in other management institutes in the world, they will say that the 2 years is like real confinement. You start in the morning till late night, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, unka WhatsApp band ho jata hai, unka Facebook band ho jata hai, because they don't have time. They are just put into that grinding, you know, situation. That is important for you to make your career, your life successful for the future. So first thing I want to give is an advice to you. You are putting your footsteps to this particular program. You have to put all efforts in these 2 years. Try to get as much information, assimilate as much as possible, get more real issues from the industry, from the business, from the market, from your teachers, from your friends. 2 years, if you are able to concentrate and really come up, there is no reason why you cannot reach the heights of whatever you have in your mind. So that is a real advice to you. You won't get this 2 years at all. Because once you, a lot depends on how you are placed, where you are placed initially. So the 2 years is very important, and the little bit time which I had with your director, with Dr. Jai Singh, I am very impressed. I had only spent about 15 minutes here with him, and I am really impressed that you have one of the best facilities. It is unfortunate, it's my unfortunate that I had never known that such an institute do exist. I am in Pune only for about last 3 years, but you are lucky, you have such an infrastructure, you have such a dedicated team here, who is really thinking about bringing students like you, putting them into the business world of the country or of international business. So about 15-20 minutes I just spent with him. You are lucky that you have come to such an institute, and you have to really do justice for your career, for your future. So these are some of the general thought points which I thought I'll just... Now what do I tell you? What do you want to listen? Can anybody say? You can be a little bit frank with me. Many of your parents will be younger than me. Many of them. I think most of them. So you can be a little bit frank. What do you want to know? Or do you want to know anything? Or you're just coming and sitting because ye curriculum mein hai? Somebody. Some girls, you know, in a situation like this, have you ever noticed? Wo aankh se aankh milana sabko dar lagta hai. Nobody wants to look at your eyes, the man who is speaking. Because, dekh le, will he point me out? This is natural. Absolutely natural. I want to tell you one thing on this. You know, one of the biggest fear we have in our life, the biggest fear, is fear of failure. We all are afraid of failing. Nobody wants to fail. And that is one reason why we fail. Because we have a fear of failure. I want to tell you one thing. I was like you. I was also like you. One of the biggest difficult thing for me in my life was somebody says, "Tum jaake baat karo." I'm telling you, I used to be, you know, bolte kai baar bolte, you shivering. Literally, I used to shiver when somebody says, "Why don't you go and give a talk?" So the company, I'm talking even some years back, couple of years back, the company where I used to work before, I used to work for a US company in Chennai. from 95 to 2007. So there we have every 2 months there is a good program of senior management. It's all senior management. And some experts from all over the world will come and talk. And end of the talk, somebody has to give a summary of whatever he has taught. It has two advantages. One, everybody has to pay attention because the summary, you know, if you don't pay attention to what he's talking, you will not know what he has spoken. So you have to make a summary. Second, it helps you to, you know, that public speaking is a very important aspect, particularly for all of you who are in the management students. Public speaking is very, very essential for you. So I used to be like you, though I was in the senior management category. So I used to be very shy of speaking, very scared of speaking. The fear is what? I go and I talk some nonsense, mere friends mere mazak udayenge. This happens. It happens in class. Forget it. It happens in class. You would have seen that you want to ask a question. The teacher says, any doubts? Everybody will keep silent. Everybody will keep silent. Because why? You think, if I ask something, if that question happened to be a foolish question, everybody will laugh at me. You know, what is your fear? Your fear is, I may ask something and people may make fun of me. That is the fear. Mind you, you are actually not asking a question, you are not asking a doubt which you could not understand just because of that word fear. And then when you talk of fear, I'm digressing my talk. So I thought I'll just... When you talk of fear, all such cases, suppose I asked a question. You had said something, I'm sure you will not say anything wrong, but even assuming something, somebody has said something absolutely which is not relevant, what will happen is, at the most, bahar jayenge, arey, kya question pucha tumne? Foolish. Two fellows will say, five fellows will say, forget it. Are you going to lose anything? Are you going to lose anything? No. And the same thing when I talked about that school, the classroom, you get a bit scared of asking. You find somebody else is asking a question. Arey, yehi toh mera bhi doubt tha. You say that, no? This doubt I had, but I didn't ask. He has asked. And every fear, every failure, the fear of failure, every failure, you get a chance to succeed again. Is there any failure in life where you don't get a chance? You get. Every failure in life, you get a chance. The only time where you don't get a chance. The only time where you don't get a chance. Can anybody tell where is it? When is it? You know, you don't get a repeat. Otherwise, you can always repeat. Which are?
Very good morning, sir. Myself, my name is Umang. I am from Bokaro Steel City, Jharkhand. Sir, the answer to your question is, when a person is not willing to grab the opportunity present in front of him, if the opportunity is in front of him and he is very much hesitant that should I grab the opportunity, and he is not very much confident, then he will not succeed unless and until he tries to do something with enthusiasm and strong willpower. He cannot succeed. He will not do better unless and until he is very much pretty sure that yes, if I do that particular thing, then my work will be succeeded and I can create an identity among the people.
Good. It's good. Very good point. I am at least happy that you could stand up and convey what you felt. That's a very important point. The point which I was saying, you know, I said fear of failure. Okay. And I said, you fail, you get a chance. Chahe, if today I ask somebody to come, you don't talk well, or somebody is saying, why don't you give a speech? You don't, but you can again go home, practice for the next time, and come very well prepared. So you have a chance. You don't do well in exam, you can get a chance. You are not, you don't know how to dress well, for example. You come shabbily. You have a chance to again repeat that thing. You know, somebody makes fun of you, they go type and nothing near that. But we are scared. One area, one thing which in our life where you don't get a repeat, you never get, and that is death. Death. Are you afraid of death? If I ask that question, no. I'm telling you no, because it never comes to your mind. It never comes to your mind about death. Because that's the only place where you do not get a repeat. Your mother tells, beta, bike samal ke jana, bahut traffic hai, bahut ganda. You don't bother, you sheesh. Knowing very well that you may meet with an accident. You are intentionally going, knowing very well, the result of this could be fatal, mind you. That is psychology. And I am saying you are not scared of death. You go riff-raff, you find people standing on the railway train and, you know, putting their hand outside. You find all those things, no? But you are scared of coming and giving a talk. You are scared of asking a question. This is what I want you to remove from your mind. You be scared of death. Don't be scared of anything in your life. So from today onwards, one lesson you learn from me, I will not be scared. What will happen? Somebody will make fun. Let him make fun, no? Does your value go down? I'm sure you would have heard about that famous example people give. If I have a 500 rupee note in my hand, okay, have you heard of that example? How many of you have heard? You not heard? Yes or no? No. Okay. Everybody knows the value of this? 100 rupees? Jab bank se aata hai, kadak kadak. Sab log bolte hai, jo dukandar bhi bolte hai, kadak note do bhai, kadak, achha achha do. Uski value kitni hai? 100 rupees. उसके बाद चला घूमता चलता है अब मेरे हाथ से गिर गया है कभी कई बार होता है हम लोग घर पे कपड़े में गिर जाता है और मम्मी भी उसको देखती नहीं है वो धुल जाता है फिर यू नो पूरा इट गेट्स क्रम्पल्ड ओके देन व्हाट हैपेंस डस द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस कम्स डाउन नो इजंट इट एग्जैक्टली सो द वैल्यू ऑफ दैट इवन ए क्रम्पल्ड नोट पानी में भीग गया है उसको भी उसको सुखा के उसको थोड़ा हल्का सा आयन भी कर देते हैं ताकि वो सीधा हो जाए द वैल्यू इज स्टिल 100 रुपीज सो लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू वन सिंपल फंडामेंटल थिंग योर वैल्यू नोबडी कैन चेंज योर वैल्यू कीप दैट इन माइंड योर वैल्यू इज योर वैल्यू यू आर लाइक दिस 100 रुपी नोट आप खड़े हो गए यहां पे कुछ फूलिश बात कर दी आपकी वैल्यू कम नहीं होगी यू फेल समवेयर इन ए प्रोग्राम देयर इज अ क्विज प्रोग्राम यू डोंट डू वेल डजंट मैटर योर वैल्यू सो कीप दैट इन माइंड वन ऑफ द फंडामेंटल थिंग्स आई वांट टू टेल यू इज योर वैल्यू इज ओनली यू रियलाइज एंड नेवर फियर अबाउट योर वैल्यू You know, Dhirubhai Ambani, the founder of Reliance Industries, his very famous statement to his staff, when I mean staff, I mean his people who's working with him. He says, आपको अपनी काबिलियत के बारे में मालूम नहीं है. दिस इज एग्जैक्टली ही सेज, यू डोंट नो योर वैल्यू. एंड आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट इज अ फैक्ट. मोस्ट ऑफ अस डोंट नो अवर वैल्यू. हैव यू एवर सीन, यू गो टू ए, यू हैव नॉट येट गॉन, इट विल टेक टाइम. इफ यू गो टू एन इंटरव्यू, 5-10 लोग बैठे हुए हैं, सपोज इन इंटरव्यू और इवन फॉर एडमिशन, और आई डोंट नो इफ यू हैव एन इंटरव्यूज और टेस्ट फॉर द एडमिशन, फॉर यू व्हेन यू गो फॉर एन इंटरव्यू, यू सी सम हाफ ए डजन पीपल सिटिंग देयर, यू लुक एट देम, यू ओनली लुक एट द गुड पॉइंट्स. तो बड़ा स्मार्ट लग रहा है ये तो आदमी, ही इज गुड, सी द वे ही इज टॉकिंग, सपोज हिज इंग्लिश इज फैंटास्टिक. सो यू बिकम ऑलरेडी नर्वस, यू आर नर्वस, माइंड यू आर नर्वस. You are looking at the good points of that man and you are only trying to, aap apni kabiliyat ko gira rahe hai. You understand Hindi, no, most of you? Yes, because I was thinking that it's only a Marathi crowd, then it will, I feel more comfortable speaking in both these languages together. That's the reason I use the words. So what Dhirubhai Ambani says, aapko apni kabiliyat par bharosa hona chahiye. And I am telling the same thing to you. You, we, all of us, we always think that, you know, you always think that I am not good looking, I am not handsome, I am not smart, I am not capable, I don't have this, other person has got this, other person has got this, other person has got this. Change that. Change that feeling. You go tomorrow to a, in your job, in your career, in your life, you should think, I have something unique. I have something unique with none of these people. If this batch is, I don't know how much the batch may be, of 90 or so. If this batch is 90, she should feel that I have something unique which 89 people don't have it. The 89 may have something else, but something I have got which nobody has got. So one of the points which you should look at your career, you should think that you are unique, you are capable. You may fail. You may fail. You will fail. Does anybody know Usain Bolt? Yes. Any of the girls know Usain Bolt? Any of the girls have heard the name of Usain Bolt? Who said yes? You said yes. Who doesn't know Usain Bolt? The girls. Who doesn't know Usain Bolt? Not that it is going to make any difference. Huh? Knowing Usain Bolt or not knowing Usain Bolt is not going to make. Somebody said she knows Usain Bolt. Who said? Who is Usain Bolt?
He's the fastest runner in the
world. Absolutely right. Absolutely right. Usain Bolt is the fastest runner in the world. 100 meters, some 9 point something. Okay? What is common between Usain Bolt and you? What's your name?
Sir, my name is Parul
Pawar.
Huh? My name is Parul Pawar. I'm from Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Sir, I find that the similarity between Usain Bolt and ourselves is that we are chasing. We are chasing at every moment. Like he races, he chases for the for his victory. And likewise, we are also chasing for something.
Absolutely good. Absolutely. So what Parul said definitely has a lot of substance into it. Lot of substance. But what I wanted to say is what is common between all of you. And Usain Bolt is, yes, I'm happy, at least there is a...
A very good morning to you, sir. My name is Prakhar Khare and I am from Sagar MP. A basic similarity which I see that both are human beings.
Good, very good. What I wanted to tell you about Usain Bolt and you, in the specific context of failure, in the context of failure, Usain Bolt also, as a child, has fallen down n number of times, घुटने टूटे होंगे, घुटने पे खरोचे आई होगी. हिज नी वुड हैव गॉट इंजर्ड व्हाइल रनिंग. Nobody, no human being, whether it is you or me, when we start walking, he also would have fallen down. Number of times he would have fallen down. But he got up, ran, then as you rightly said, chased the record. So what I want to tell you is, I was just talking about failure. Failure should never, ever allow you to see to it that you don't reach your goal. It's easy to say. I'm telling you, it's difficult. In real life, there will be a lot of challenges. You will find that, you know, in the corporate world, you will find that you are not getting promotion. Somebody else is getting promotion. These are things which is going to happen in real life. Let me be very honest. It's not that like a classroom, you know, when you write the question papers, you know the answers, everybody knows the answers, and you know it can't change. But in a real life situation, it will be different. You want to come up to that level, top, and you find somebody else comes and he gets the promotion, you don't get it. Then you is company mein kaam karne se kya fayda? No, you get all those things. Never get disillusioned. If you have your value, if you are able to keep up your spirit and you have the goal. One of the most important points when I talked about goal, you should have goal in life. All of you, I'm sure you would have goals. Who doesn't have goal? Does anybody in this hall doesn't have goal? All have goals. You don't have goal. What's your goal? What's your name? You are from? Gorakhpur. There's a very famous temple, Gorakhnath temple there. Am I right? Okay. Good. Tell, what's your goal?
The CEO in that bank.
Your short term is an HR manager in a bank. Yes. Why a bank? Why a bank?
Sir, I would like to work in a bank.
Because they give more money?
No, sir.
Then why?
Sir, I have a dream of to work with an NGO and have NGO which would work, which would like to work for women empowerment. Sir, I would like to work in a bank because bank gives many opportunities to finance that and sorry, I don't know what
to do. No problem. Good. You have a goal, that's more important. You have On a lighter vein, you know, you said, I want to do this women's empowerment, I want to do this. So, oh, rata rataya answer to nahi hai na? You know, in this beauty pageants, the beauty pageants, you ask, what do you want? I want to be like Mother Teresa. Almost 85% of the girls will say, I want to be like Mother Teresa. I used to be in the interview board for the IAS. you may be aware of the civil services, and in the final interviews when they have, so I had been about 3-4 years, I was in the panel. Most of the students, they are not students, they are all well qualified. Many of them are doctors. Nowadays, you know, in IAS you find doctors and IPS you find doctors. So you ask them, oh, you're a doctor and why do you want to come into this service? You know what they say? Humko society ki society mein service karna hai. Kya doctor ban ke society mein service nahi kar sakte? To wo rata rata hai jo coaching class se answer milta hai wo bolte hai. Boliye.
Sir, I belongs to a small town and
Gorakhpur is not a small town.
Sir, there are still many villages where women don't get opportunity to of education, and they don't realize the value of education. So I want to let them know that education is very important. That's why I want to work for that.
Give a big hand to her. I'll tell you why. You know why? Her ambition, her wish, her thing is different. Many a times when I said that, is this just, you know, rataya answer to nahi hai, many people would have just kept silent and let the question pass, bolte na, pass, let the questions pass. She stood up, she justified her reason why she wants and what is the situation in her area of Gorakhpur, etc. So she stood up and said confidently. So that is the clap is for that. I forgot your name. Alkamush. Okay, good. So what I was saying is, we were discussing about your capability, your values, your commitment, your failure. All those things will happen. Now we are going to the next step. I was talking till now general things. I'll take a small presentation because since the time is up to 11, so I want to make it a bit fast. I love coming to colleges. Honestly, I didn't come here. Normally, if it was some other program in some organization or somebody, and somebody calls me at the last moment, also I go, because there's no question. It's at least you are getting a chance. So I love to come to colleges for 2-3 reasons. One reason is you mingle with young people. In my job, whom do I mingle? All at the age of 45, 50, there are few people who join every year, maybe some engineers join 10, 15, 12. You mingle with young crowd. And mingling with young crowd, I had recently gone to my alma mater, BITS Pilani. I had been there for a function that invited me. And I found that the professors and the teachers who were there, they all look slightly different than people like us. So one of the reasons I was just jokingly, I was telling them, which I'm even now to like to tell you here. You look at your managing director, Dr. Singh Saab, or you look at any of the professors, they all have, you know, young, thick hair. They never get old. So in my BITS Pilani, when I went in 2010 or somewhere I went, I found the director, the vice chancellor, everybody is full. And I was looking at me, a sab chala gaya, because of the tension or the pressure. So then I said in that lecture, I said, the professors and teachers are young because they only, what is the crowd they meet? They meet a crowd of maximum 22, 23, 25. So they are mingling with a crowd of 25. People like me mingle with a crowd of 55. So that is the difference. So when Dr. Ramdas, she called me, it's a college, I readily agreed. Okay? On a lighter, when I was saying that, let me tell you some more things about a small presentation which I said. We will flip-flop between the presentation, we'll come back. You should know what is an industry. You should know what you will do tomorrow. I was just talking to Dr. Singh, and he was mentioning that many of you are marketing, HR, finance. These are the three areas of specialization you have. And he was talking about entrepreneurship also. Am I right? That's what you mentioned. HR, finance, and marketing. These are the three very, very important things. Is there any engineers in this hall? Oh, you're all engineers. Good. Good, good, good. I'm happy, Professor, to see that you have a good cross-section of people. I found somebody from Bokaro, I found somebody from Bhopal, somebody from Gorakhpur. So it's it's a great thing because you know, I perceptions are always wrong. So my perception was it may be most of the crowd maybe from, you know, in and around. So the three people who stood up and spoke, is your father in BHL? No. Then? Okay. So the industry, you're all go to the industry. Now you'll be looking at what is industry? What do I do in industry? I'll just take you to, you have a, oh. You can all see this, no? You want to switch off this to make it clear? Or is it you are able to see? The last lady on the green saree, could you see? Yeah. You know, ultimately, it's business. You run a factory, you run a hospital, you run a college, you run a chota sa, kya bolte usko, dukan, mom pop shop they call it, anything you run, it's business. So what do? You also do, yes, Master of Business Administration. You look at the degree, what you're, it's business, ultimately it's business. So business is largely about manufacturing 5 M's: money, machine, man, material, methods. Fundamental, there's nothing great in it. But the most important is, how do you manage each of them? Managing money is obviously a very important aspect, because ultimately we run business for what? We run business for making money. Let's be very honest on that. One need not feel ashamed on that. It's a fact of life. Everyone runs business. Even he says charity, he gives charity only from the profit what he earns. He doesn't give charity without the profit. So very important is, we run business. Even if I am doing a small thing at home, I want to make money. It's not, you know, in Hindi they say munafa or munafa khori. Dono mein bahut farak hai. Profit and profiteering is different. You know, we used to hear in the earlier days, aajkal to hota nahi hai. Even now little bit it happens. In the earlier days during the Chinese war, I still remember people, we were all young students in 60s. Kerosene used to be, you know, not sold, not available in the market, because they used to sell it in black. So 2 liter ka kerosene 20 rupees mein milta tha. That is called munafa khori, profiteering, which is not correct. Agar aap 2 rupees mein petrol wo kharidta hai, wo 2.5 rupees mein bechega, bechna zaruri hai 2.5 rupees mein. It is essential. He cannot buy it at 2 rupees and sell it at 1 rupee 50 paisa. No. So profit. So managing money is perhaps one of the most important aspects of business. The business will survive only if the money is managed very well. Okay? So which is the most important? Managing money. Good. Anybody else who doesn't agree to this, that managing money is the most important? Anybody? You are this batch student? Sorry, I didn't mean anything. It's only because they will lose their... Anybody from this batch who says, she says, I was also saying money is important, but is there anybody who differs with this? Yes, the Bokaro gentleman.
Sir, according to me, apart from managing money, managing manpower is more important than money, because if you manage manpower, if you have sufficient amount of manpower, you can generate the maximum amount of output. And if maximum amount of output is generated, then only money can be managed.
Good. I'm happy you said that. I want to just catch one word which he said, which all of is an output. Yes. Somebody is showing the hand up.
Would be a better expect after managing money.
We are only saying there are five, you know, this five boxes. So, in what way is not the point. Is money the most important? Is
yeah.
the point?
Yes, sir, it's money.
Money is the most important. Yeah. Yes.
Sir, according to me, only money is not important. We have to means these all five things are interdependent on each other. Means with only money a business can't grow. If one does not have manpower, it need manpower also, then they need machinery also, they need material also, and they need a perfect method for doing it also.
So that we are already saying business is largely business is largely about managing the five M's. So that is a well-known fact that these five M's are important. I am only saying in this 5M, most of you said money is most important. You were wanting to say something. Yes, yes. You know, you put your hand so slowly. You wanted to say something, isn't it? Then you should put it like this.
Excuse me, sir. So passion for doing something is also very important. Having a dream, first of all, one should have a dream of doing something. Then only he can, means then he can arrange the methods or the path for doing it.
No, we are saying there are five things: money, man, machine, material, and methods. So there's a method how to make this item. There's a materials are needed for that. There's a money is needed for that. There's a man is needed, and one machine has to be made. So we are actually confining our things to these five things. Among the five things, some people said money is the most important because ultimately business is looked into profitability. No. Nuksan hai, faida hai. So we'll come to that. Let's listen to her.
Very good morning, sir. My name is Shetal Janawat. I'm from Indore, Madhya Pradesh. I would like to add a point to his point that money.
He's from which place?
Yes, sir.
He is from which place? Udhar mat dekho, meri taraf dekho. No, meri taraf dekho. He is from which place? Go ahead. He said he's from Bukharo.
I would like to add a point that money is important. Managing money is important, but money is managed by man only. Manpower, if in an industry or any company or organization, if manpower is good, then only money is managed by him only.
Absolutely. You said it very right. I'll come to that. Okay. You know, these 5 points is important. There is no doubt. There is no doubt. Okay? I'll come to that point a bit later on. Okay. I'll come to your point a bit later on. But you hit the bull's eye very well. Business today are operating in a constantly changing and evolving environment. If you look at today's business, what business was that 10 years back, 15 years back, it's going on changing. Today what's happening is changing customer needs and requirements. It's very important. You know, the evolution of this, every 3 months you find something new coming. Why? Because of the first point, changing customers' needs and requirement. Two, if I don't do this change based on customer's requirement, that business will get killed. That business will die. Okay? We have examples. Even now, I'm not talking older examples. Many of you may not know, there's a company called ITI, Indian Telephone Industries, which used to make the instruments, telephone instrument. Oh, almost band ho gaya hai because they had never changed looking into customer's requirement. You look at Nokia. Nokia was such an important brand just 5 years back. People used to say, "Arey, Nokia phone ke alawa koi phone nahi hai." Okay? Where is Nokia today? Because it has not done this. So, however strong you are there, if you are not doing these things, you'll be nowhere. Rapid changes in technology. Industry, business, the way the technology changes in the business, in the area, you have to go on changing it. And today, what's it? It's a globalization. In the earlier days, we used to have only a limited market. Today, you have, if I make something, I can sell all over the world. The world, China mein bante diye, Diwali mein hamare aapko jalte hai. Okay, so it's interconnected, faster communications, shifting demographies, changing social trends. Same mobile, you look at it. Earlier, today you find the mobile with almost everybody. Aapke maid servant hai, wo bhi mobile mein baat karte hai aap usse. Sabji wala hai, usko bhi baat karte hai mobile mein. Means there was a time when this used to be only for a certain level of people. But today, the changing social trends. It's so the business has to really look into all these aspects. To stay relevant in the current business environment, organizations need to be constantly improve on the 5M. We talked about the 5M earlier, okay? Now, to stay relevant in the current business environment, organizations have to improve the 5Ms. In today's environment, it is essential to give your customers what he wants. It is not only sufficient to give what he wants, faster and better. I'm telling you, that is very important. Time is essence, quality is essence. So, why the companies, you'll find all these companies, Beat and Apple, Beat, any of those companies, you look at it. You look at the motorcycle company, the amount of development the motorcycle companies do on a regular basis, motorcycle or scooty or any of those things. I mean, these are all needed because the customers want, today you are getting at 50 liters, 50 kilometers per liter, somebody is working on it to make it 55 or 60. So, in order to achieve this, organization is to constantly improve and become better and better. Better and better. You can't, there is nothing like a final absolute word. Ki bhai haan, yahan pahunch gaya, khatam. This is the end. Isse abhi mujhe aage kuch nahi kar sakta. No. Aap nahi karenge, kuch aur aake karega and you will lose. Organization excellence, up to 11, no? Time is, I'll make it fast. Organization excellence hence is a journey and not a destination. So as I said, it is a journey. It cannot, you cannot call yahan pahunch gaya main, that's finished. No. And the above mantra needs to be followed and practiced by people across all levels and functions in an organization. Can an organization just depend on, you know, in any organization you will go now, you will be going, suppose you go to a factory, you go to an industry, you go to say a service providers like telecoms. There are different areas, particularly people who are from the engineering side, you may know there is a production department, there's an engineering department, there is a marketing department, there is a sales and service department, manufacturing department, so many departments are there. Now, can you make out which department is important? No. It has to be a close-knit. You'll have to work closely with each other to see to it that you are able to. Ultimately, you are working for whom? You are working for only one person. And that is your customers. You are ultimately working for your customers. That is very, very important. There is a slogan in many places, I don't see nowadays, but earlier, many organizations used to be. Gandhiji used to say, a customer is the most important visitor in our premises. Because if the customer is not there, we are not there. To stay relevant in current business environment, workforce is the differentiator between you and the competition. Now, this is the essence. What was your name? Payal. Shekhar. Shetal. Okay. You had said it very correctly. This is the most important, still relevant in the current business environment. Workforce is a differentiator. You look at this. Now, there are two organizations. This is one, and that is another one. Two organizations. Sit down. Two organizations, two companies doing the same type of business. Same type of business. Okay? Money, both are getting from State Bank of India. Same interest rate, same things are there. Machine, you are making, say, for example, pizza. Food industries, pizza. Same recipe hai, same wo hai, uska machine bhi Italy se import kiya, aapne bhi kiya Italy se import. Ekdam, wo bhi 3 minute mein wo laga ke aa jata hai, idhar bhi 3 minute mein aa jata hai, kuch. So machine is same. Method bhi wahi hai, common method hai, suppose dono ka. Material wahi hai, the same base, the same whatever you make it, you have this topping, you have that topping, whatever, it is exactly same. Can you get the same man? No. You can't get the same man. So the only differentiator is, if all other things are there, the people. The people are the most important asset in an organization. The organization succeeds or failure on account of people. Aap केला खरीदने जाते हैं, सिंपल सी बात है, केला खरीदने जाते हैं या सब्जी खरीदने जाते हैं, वो सब्जी वाला उगाता नहीं है, वो केले वाली जो बेचती है, शी गेट्स दो ठेले हैं, आप एक ठेले से लेते हो, वही के दोनों के फर्क नहीं है, because of the behavior of that particular person, दाम वही है, केला वही है, सब कुछ है, so one thing which is important for you to note is, you as individuals will be responsible for the success or failure of your organization. That is most important, which I want to leave this message to you. You think I'm too junior a person, how does it make a difference? It makes hell of a lot of difference. In any organization, it's only the people. I'll give a small example. When I joined my company in 1973, I had come from Pilani, and I'm talking in those days. You know, many of you who are engineers, they will realize you, when you come out of engineering, you want to do a lot of engineering activities. You know, you think you pada hai, I'll do this, ye design karenge, wo design. So I was very keen to join R&D. I wanted to be in research and development. But my bosses said, no, you should go in marketing. So I was not very comfortable. I was thinking that marketing mein kya, you know, tie wai pen ke jana padega. I'm talking 1970s ki baat hai. It may not be very interesting. So he told me a very interesting point to sell the idea that you should join marketing. He said, in any organization, only two people matter. Listen to my words. In any organization, only two people matter. One who makes it, and one who sells it. Have you got my point? So there are only two people. One who manufactures, jo banata hai, aur jo bechta hai. In simple Hindi words. So, किसी भी संस्था में दो आदमी है जो बनाता है और जो बेचता है. बाकी सब लोग are running errands for these two people. चाहे materials का आदमी हो, चाहे HR का आदमी हो, they are all running errands for these two people. Only these two people are very important. And between the two, the marketing man is more important, because जो बनाता है उसको कुछ बनाना पड़ता है. अगर ये आपको ये बनाना है remote, तो बनाना पड़ेगा. जो बेचता है, हवा में भी बहुत सारी चीजें बेच देता है, बिना बनाए वो बेच देता है. इट वाज दैट्स व्हाट he was in turn telling me that sales is more important, and in sales you can sell ideas, you can sell vision, you don't have to really make it. So that in reality it happened to me, okay? And it's a fact, many organizations, the people who come to the top after marketing, many organizations all over the world, though now finance has started coming, HR has started coming now, these are the, but even now the trend is the marketing man, because he is the face of the company. I used to be a marketing man all my life, okay? All my life, 42 years, though I had taken different positions, but still, in my heart, I am a salesman. But I'll tell you one thing. I have changed that philosophy of that my gentleman who taught me. Today, in an organization, only one person make. Only one person. There's only one which is important. And that is human being. The human capital. Ladies and gentlemen, you cannot survive today if you do not have the best people. And people with commitment. People with real dedication. So this is what I said. People are the most important thing. Anyway. There's not much of. You could get that, Dr. Singh, could you get that thing? Oh. I'll just tell you, not now. I have bought some more slides, but it will take a lot of time, so I have only bought 10 minutes more. So, are you getting bored? It is not only to make me happy or saying no. But no, in any case, I also have to leave at 11. What is important is, I'll just tell you now two, three, just small tips. I'll give a small presentation about my company to know how an industry looks. Why don't you put that film? Because then I can, whatever time is left, I'll close it. Ek film hai na usme? Laga sakte? Haan. इसको बंद कर दो लाइट को. वॉल्यूम है.
October 22nd, 2008, Chandrayaan 1, India's first spacecraft mission to the moon, marked a major technological leap for the country. Many critical components for the launch vehicle of this high-tech mission were manufactured by one of India's foremost heavy engineering companies. Walchandnagar Industries Limited. A continuing legacy of engineering for tomorrow. Walchandnagar Industries has been associated with the Indian Space Research Organization since its inception and was the first Indian company to manufacture critical components for their Polar satellite launch vehicle. Again, the first in India to manufacture all the critical core equipment for nuclear power plants. The first to manufacture main gearboxes for the Indian Navy frigates and corvette class ships, also manufacturing the largest optical telescope in India. Following the legacy of Seth Walchand Hirachand, a visionary industrialist who founded some of the key industries in pre-independent India. Pioneer in aircraft manufacturing, maritime shipping, shipbuilding, automobiles, construction of dams, bridges, tunnels, Hume pipes, power projects, heavy engineering and manufacturing of industrial machinery and plants. Walchand Nagar, once a barren land in rural Maharashtra, has transformed into a role model industrial township. A special engineering zone with a conducive environment designed for comfortable living, working and learning. Today, Walchand Nagar Industries is a diversified, high-tech, heavy engineering and project execution company, recognized as a preferred supplier to a wide spectrum of industries around the world. High-pressure boilers for steam and power generation. Turnkey independent power projects. The first in India to execute an independent power project based on municipal solid waste, cement machinery and turnkey cement plants. The first company from India to export a complete cement plant with the largest kiln ever manufactured in India. The complete range of sugar machinery and turnkey sugar plants. Walchand Nagar was the first company to build an indigenous sugar plant and first to export sugar machinery and a complete sugar project from India. Specialized equipment for nuclear power plants, a wide range of defense equipment and critical components for aerospace. At Walchand Nagar, future needs take shape on computer screens. Establishing design and development departments dedicated to core industrial sectors. The latest systems and software enable critical thermal and mechanical design, finite analysis, and 3D modeling and simulation, which are then integrated with computer-aided manufacturing. The manufacturing facilities are developed on par with the best in the world, and in compliance with all national and international codes. Heavy lifting of single piece equipment weighing up to 125 metric tons. One of the largest horizontal lathes and vertical boring machines installed in Asia. And a series of large CNC vertical boring machines. Dedicated zones for exclusive manufacture of technology-intensive components for nuclear power, aerospace and defense projects. Special zones for boiler manufacturing, cement machinery division, sugar plant machinery division and a gear division for heavy-duty industrial and marine gears, equipped with the latest high-precision CNC gear grinding station. Large dust-free halls for critical assembly and precision welding. Multiple heat treatment furnaces to meet the demanding requirements of critical and large-sized products. Mastering multiple technologies for welding, developing special fixtures for high accuracy and distortion-free welding. Walchand Nagar has put into place specialized systems and practices for quality management, conforming to international codes as well as meeting customers' stringent specifications. Enclosed areas for X-ray radiography. A specially created underground testing pit for high pressure and strain gauge testing. Developing unique capabilities in project management. Driven by a team of experienced professionals, providing total solutions through EPC projects for mineral processing, petrochemicals, oil and gas, and other industrial sectors. Constantly updating know-how through global technology partnerships. Globally, Walchand Nagar is expanding its footprint in countries across South Asia, the Middle East, Africa, Europe, and the Americas. Walchand Nagar's continuous high performance has been recognized by the Indian government's awards for technology absorption and export performances. Today, Walchandnagar epitomizes the spirit of a progressive India. A self-supporting township that offers quality education and advanced healthcare. With a school recognized for its academic excellence and a hospital with all modern facilities. Nurturing young talents in sports with facilities that are comparable with the best in urban India. Pioneering a tradition of community welfare. Providing free education for rural people since 1934. Initiatives for sustainable development of the poor through adult literacy and self-employment schemes. Creating excellence in harmonious living and teamwork at the workplace. An empowered team constantly striving to exceed expectations of customers and stakeholders. For Walchandnagar Industries Limited, it's a continuous mission of engineering the future of industry and society.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was a glimpse of the organization where I now work. It's a large organization, as I said, 106-year-old company. And it's into various fields. You already seen what is shown on the film. I thought I'll just give a glimpse of that for you to know. We are more of an engineering industry. Do a little bit into design engineering, plus turnkey, and you would have seen we do very specialized job for the space, for the nuclear, for, you know, all these Akash missiles, you'll see, those are the things. It's really a privilege for me to be part of this great organization. I'll keep that aside. There are 5 minutes more. I'll try to just wrap up the whole point. You know, in a program like this, which you have embarked for the 2-year PGDM program, I can only in a matter of one and a half hours give you some insight into what you are going to actually face in the real life. The real life will be not like this. No. No. Whether you and you work in a bank, you when you look from outside, the bank looks very good, but when you really go into it, it's a challenge. It's a real challenge. As she said, you race against everything. There's a race. There's a constant race is there. Because one of the things which is important in any business is like it should be like a river. It cannot be stagnant. The moment something is stagnant, it starts stinking. So, you know, it's important. It flows. And the real life for you will flow. But I would like to tell you one thing. Never fear the real life. The real life is very good. One or two small points I'll tell you. To be successful in your professional career, many times people say, you know, pouch honi chahiye, boss se, jaan pehchan honi chahiye. I'm just telling you, really, nothing is needed. Nothing is needed. If you are good at your work, if you are sincere with your work, everybody wants you. If I want a team of 11 players in my team, and if what is the aim for the captain of the team? To win. Does anybody want to lose a match? No, never. Even if you are the weakest team, you have an opponent who is very strong. जब हम match में उतरते हैं, हम सोचते हैं आज तो जीतना है. तुक से उनका अगर player को चोट लग जाए या वो out हो जाए, so you always want to win. You write an exam, you go to an exam. Do you think you think I am going to fail today? दोस्तों में बोल सकते होंगे मजाक में मैंने कुछ पढ़ाई नहीं किया. There are many people who say that, you know, I didn't study anything. But heart of heart, you want to write, you want to succeed. Nobody wants to fail. you also should have that in mind, that you will never fail. You will fail, but that's also, you will fail. You expect 90 marks, you are getting 75 marks. It will happen. Don't think it will not happen. You expect a promotion, you will not get it. It will happen. Never lose courage. Last point I want to tell you is, I know many times it has come to many places, but still, as a point, I want to say, you know, the knowledge is very important. Very important. Nobody, the college where I used to study, I still remember the emblem. In that it is written, Jnanam Paramam Balam. There is nothing like knowledge. Knowledge is power supreme. Without knowledge, you cannot survive in today's world. Hard work is equally important. You are aware about that some mathematical thing is there? Are you all aware? Have you read it anywhere? Not. Okay, I'll take half a minute, less than half a minute. You know, people say, I'll give 100%. If somebody talked about passion, I'll give 100%. We all say, you know, interview mein poochte, kitna, how will you do? Sir, I'll main apna 100% isme jaan laga dunga. People say that, we also say that. Okay, what is 100%? What is 100%? So, one is 100%, I give full knowledge. So, there is a mathematical thing, you may go home or after the class, you can do that. Three important things in life is that one is knowledge. If you put knowledge, K-N-O-W-L-E-D-G-E, knowledge, you spell karo, usko aap A1, B2, C, Z26, agar aap add karenge, it comes to 96. Hard work is equally important. You write hard work, and again you do that. Add that alphabetical alphabets. A is 1, it comes to 98. And if you do attitude, it comes 100. It's not that I had devised it. It's a meaning is there. One thing which really will make or mar your life, one thing which is most important for you is your attitude. If you have a positive attitude in life, positive attitude to your organization. And one thing I want to tell you, consider your organization as your own life. Own life. I'm telling you, I'm using the word own life because the see, most of you may be 22, 21, I don't know. It will be around less than 25. That range. Okay? You will have a career of minimum next 35, 40 years. All. You should expect to work till, if you are working, till say 60, 65, depending on that. 40 years career. I am sure nobody is going to live, most of you, I don't want to say that, most of you will not live another 40 years. You are not going to live more than, nobody wants to live after 100 years. Century, cricket mein achha lagta hai, life mein century ki jarurat nahi hai. So the maximum period of your life, you are going to devote to organization. Wherever you are working, whether you are doing your own NGO, whether you are doing something else. So the maximum period of your life is the one which is most productive period of your life. It will have all the changes in your life. You will get married. You'll have a house, you'll have a car, you'll have a children, you'll become grandparents. The whole thing is there in the next 35 to 40 years where you have the work. If we have to be strong there, you have to have a very positive attitude. Very positive attitude. And with this word, I would like to close my talk. I would like to really wish each one of you who have enrolled in this program of PGDM in this university, in this college, in this institute, a very successful future, a very happy 2 years in this institute. I am glad you selected such an institute, and I am happy that you find a lot of people from different areas. May God bless all of you, and keep one word in mind, you will be always two things. No fear from today, no fear at all, bulldoze. And second, have a very positive attitude. Thank you very much. Any questions you want? Or you have a time? Half a minute or something? Okay. I forgot to ask that because yes.
Sir, my name is Supriya Singh. I am from Durg, Chhattisgarh. And my question to you is, sir, can we get a chance to visit your industry?
Yes.
And sir, one more question
from
I would...
the institute, if there is a request.
Okay, sir. Sir, and one more question I would like to ask you that, what qualities you want in your employers?
Two qualities I said, no? No fear and attitude, positive attitude.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Good morning, sir. My name is Nyanada Bagmare. I am from Nagpur. Sir, I have done my engineering in mechanical. So, sir, I want one question that in many core industries, you know, we have our college taken many placements like core industries. So, there is one means difference that I found in a lot of the girls and a lot of my many friends. We are not placed. That we have like means there is difference between like boys should also get preference, first preference to the core industry. So why is this the difference still in this era? I mean, still in this present area.
Good point. I personally feel there should not be any difference. Let me tell you, I was reading somewhere, I think yesterday or somewhere, in the company where I worked in 1975. In Kerala, the shop floor, there were ladies on the machine shop. They were running two critical machines. So, personally, I feel there is no reason why. It all depends perhaps on the cultural of that particular area, you know. But otherwise, I have got in Valsanagar Industries, young girls, local girls, engineering graduates, mechanical engineering graduates, on the shop floor. And going to, you know, some of those equipments, what you're saying, is a very critical equipment. They go down inside and do the working there. Anybody else?
Thank you, sir.
One question, last, if there is. Yeah.
Good morning, sir. My name is Aditi Jadhav. I'm from Dhar, Madhya Pradesh. Sir, like you said, we should not hesitate. All the questions that you asked today, I had answers for everything, but sir, I could not raise my hands. Like the first question you asked, the moment you stopped the question, I said to my friend, death. Like the answer is death, but I couldn't raise my hand and say. Sir, so how do we remove these hesitations, sir? Few things that you can share.
You are like me. I used to also be like that. You are like this 89 students in this room. They are also like that. So, as I said, all of us have that fear.
Yes.
You know, that is the point I said. All of us have that fear. So when I parted, I said, we should throw the fear away. Throw the fear away. And that can happen not by telling you, you have to on your own say that I am going to be bindas. I'll ask or I'll say. So if you remove that fear of, you know, mera mazak udayenge ye log, hasi udayenge. If you remove that, nothing to worry. Okay.
Sir.
So you are not different. You are exactly this 90 people, including me. I used to be like this.
Yes, sir.
But we'll have to change.
Yes.
We'll have to change. Okay.
Yes. Thank you.